Now I'm going to discuss section 80 CCG. Sure. Hey, this is inserted by Finance Act 2012. Who is that? What? Amended by Finance Act 2013. Section 80 CCG applies to whom? To resident individual. A, there are sections which allows deduction for all individuals, and there are sections which say resident. So note, not to all resident individuals whose gross total income doesn't exceed 12 lakhs. Doesn't exceed 12 lakhs. Acquired listed equity shares. The assessee acquires listed equity shares or listed units of equity-oriented funds. Equity-oriented fund. In accordance with a scheme, in accordance with a scheme notified by central government, acquired, assessee acquired listed equity shares or listed units of equity-oriented funds in accordance with scheme notified by the central government. Whether any scheme is notified by the central government, you need to know. Yes, the scheme notified is Rajiv Gandhi Equity Savings Scheme 2013. Acquired listed equity shares or listed units of equity oriented fund in accordance with the scheme notified by the central government. A equity oriented fund is nothing but a mutual fund, okay, where not less than 65% of its investable funds are only invested in equity shares, are only invested in equity shares. Number 4, assessee is a new retail investor. Assessee is a new retail investor. Please listen. Who is a new retail investor? An individual who has not opened DMAT account. In company law, they would have taught you dematerialization. So an individual who has not opened DMAT account and has not made any transaction in the derivative segment, that person is called new retail investor. What is the quantum of deduction? It is 50% of amount invested or rupees 25,000, whichever is less. to consolidate before I proceed further, deduction under this section is available to whom? To a resident individual, not to every resident individual whose gross total income, doesn't exceed 12 lakhs and who acquires listed equity shares or listed units of equity oriented fund in accordance with the scheme notified by the central government. Is there any scheme notified by the central government? Yes. Rajiv Gandhi Equity Savings Scheme 2013. And as per that scheme should be a new retail investor. Who is a new retail investor? An individual who has not opened DMAT account and has not made any transaction in the derivative segment. What is the quantum of deduction? 50% of amount invested or 25,000, whichever is less. How long the deduction will be available? It is only for 3 years. Number 6. Period of deduction. Period of deduction. 3 consecutive assessment years beginning with the assessment year relevant to the previous year in which listed equity shares or listed equity oriented units were first acquired. In which year the acquisition is made for the first time, from that year for 3 years, the deduction is available. Deduction is available for how many years? 3 consecutive assessment years beginning with assessment year relevant to the previous year in which listed equity shares or listed equity oriented units were first acquired. There is lock-in period condition. In exemption under 54 series you discuss lock-in period, na? Here also there is lock-in period condition. The lock-in period is 3 years from the date of acquisition. 3 years. This is the lock-in period. That means it should not be sold. Then assessee shall comply with such other conditions, as may be prescribed, shall comply with such other conditions as may be prescribed. But if this lock-in period condition or other condition is violated, na, in the year of violation, the deduction already granted will be withdrawn. If the condition supra violated, supra means above, or violated, the deduction granted is withdrawn, in the previous year of violation, and there is bar on double deduction. That means if you enjoy deduction in respect of this under this section, you will not get deduction elsewhere under any other section. There is bar on double deduction. See, now to visualize, I am having two good illustrations which I am going to incorporate in the material, no need to copy, just listen. Listen to me, I am going to do an illustration. Please. Mr. X and Mr. Y, new retail investors, have made the following investments in equity shares or units of equity oriented funds of Rajiv Gandhi Savings Scheme for the previous year 13, 14, 14, 15 and 15, 16, 3 years. First take Mr. X. In the year 13-14, how much he has invested in listed equity shares? 20,000. How much he has invested in units of equity oriented fund? 40,000. I need a response.
Yes,
total amount invested all? 60,000. On that 50% is what?
30,000.
Or 25,000, whichever is less. 25,000 will be allowed as a deduction. Gross total income is not exceeding 12 lakhs. Tell. So therefore deduction is allowed under section 80 C C G. Resident individual, new retail investor, gross total income doesn't cross 12 lakhs. Investment is made. Tell. For the next year 14-15, investment in listed equity shares, how much? 45,000, 50% is what? 22,500. Or 25,000, which is less? 22,500. That much should be the deduction under ATCCG. But here, the deduction is available because the gross total income doesn't exceed 12 lakhs. I need a response.
Yes, sir.
Third year investment is what? 32,000. 11,000. Total is how much? 43,000. 43,000 like 50% is what? 21,500. 21,500 or 25,000, which is less? 21,500. But that will not be allowed as a deduction. Why? Gross total income is more than 12 lakhs. Not eligible for deduction. Tell.
Yes, sir.
Fine. This is regarding Mr. X. Regarding Mr. Y. Investment in listed equity shares 25,000. Investment in units of equity oriented funds 15,000. Total 40,000. 50% is? 20,000. 20,000 or 25,000, which is less? 20,000. That will be the deduction. Tell here.
Yes, sir.
Here the gross total income doesn't exceed 12 lakhs. So therefore 20,000 will be the deduction. Tell. Come to the next year. Next year, how much is invested? 40,000. Adala 50% is what? 20,000. 20,000 or 25,000, which is less? 20,000. But here, gross total income is more than 12 lakhs. No deduction. No deduction. Come to the third year. Investment in listed equity shares, how much? Equity oriented funds, how much? Total, how much? 55,000, 50% is what? 27,500. Or 25,000, which is less? 25,000. Tell.
Yes, sir.
That should be allowed as a deduction under 80 CCG. Keep it separate. We will decide that. In the current year, what happens? Lock-in period condition is violated. This should be held for 3 years. This should be held for 3 years. But this is sold within 3 years. Sale of all units of equity oriented fund. All. This is also transferred. This is also transferred. You violate lock-in period condition of 3 years here. You violate lock-in period condition of 3 years here. It is sold within 3 years. 70,000 rupees. 70,000 rupees. It is sold for 70,000 rupees. That means the exemption granted should be withdrawn. But there is no need for withdrawing the exemption here, because in 1415 no exemption was given. No deduction was given. What was the deduction given? Zero. So question of withdrawal doesn't arise. But here deduction was granted. This deduction should be withdrawn. But entire deduction cannot be withdrawn, because the deduction under 80CCG is traceable to investment in shares as well as investment in equity oriented units. I am talking to you. You should withdraw that portion of the deduction which is attributable to what? Investment in equity oriented units. What was the deduction you enjoyed? 20,000. 20,000 into 15,000 divided by 40,000. That is the deduction traceable to this 15,000, 7,500. That deduction should be withdrawn. Withdrawn means what? That should be assessed to tax. That should be gross total income is what? 11,50,000. Plus what we are going to tax? 7,500. Total is how much? 11,57,500. Still less than 12 lakhs. For this year you have invested 55,000. On that 55,000, 50% is 27,500. Or 25,000, which is less? 25,000. 25,000 will be allowed as a deduction. And 7,500 will be assessed to tax. It's a very good illustration here. So, shall I repeat this again?
Yes,
yes, yes. I should. I know. First take, stage by stage. First take the previous year, 13, 14. In that year, how much is invested? I need a response, lazy fellows. 40,000. 40,000, 50% is what? 20,000 or 25,000? 20,000 should be allowed because gross total income is less than 12 lakhs. Correct? Second year, how much you invested? On that 50% is what? 20,000 or 25,000? But can we allow deduction? Why? More than 12 lakhs. First 2 years, CPT level year. There is no need to repeat again. Third year, in which lock-in period condition is violated. These units were transferred. Lock-in period condition violated. In the year of violation, whatever deduction granted will be withdrawn. But these units were transferred. But deduction enjoyed. So question of withdrawal doesn't arise. These units transferred. Violation. For this deduction was enjoyed. That should be withdrawn. How we should withdraw? Deduction enjoyed for this year is what? 20,000. But how much of this 20,000 is traceable to units? 20,000 into 15,000 divided by 40,000. Which is what? 7,500. Only out of 20,000, 7,500 is the deduction traceable to investment in equity oriented units. That alone can be withdrawn. That alone can be withdrawn. So what we shall do in this year, it should be assessed to tax. Already 11,50,000 plus 7,500. Total how much? 11,57,500. Less than 12 lakhs. So therefore this year investment is made. How much made? Out of that 50% is what? 27,500 or 25,000, which is less? 25,000 should be allowed as a deduction. Tell?
Yes, sir.